Yeah, thanks, Emilia, for your introduction. I'm glad to take this opportunity today. My name is Martin Gröbel, and I'm working as a product marketing manager for Magic Power Modules for Wood Electronics since March 2020. Today, I will introduce you to our online designing tool, Red Expert, and how we simulate the thermal behavior of our Magic Power Modules with it. To start, I want to give you a quick overview about the topic we are talking about for the next 30 minutes. As some of you may never have used Red Expert before, first I'll give you a short expression on what a Red Expert is and what the tool can be used for. Therefore, for the next step, I'll show you the possibilities to get quick access to our tool. After the successful login follows the introduction to the handling of Red Expert. Now we have all the knowledge that we need to handle the tool. Therefore, as a next step, we go into the explanation of the thermal simulation. And at last, I give you a practical example for module selection using a real application. So let's start with the introduction of Red Expert. The basic means of Red Expert is to search for the most suitable product based on your given application requirements. To achieve this, you can find all needed specifications of our Magic Power Modules and the module-related features listed on Red Expert. Furthermore, you get relevant performance curves, like the efficiency of the module plotted in different diagrams. Due to the fact that most of the times more than one module fits to your requirements, you can even compare two or more modules to each other. But now the question is, where can I find it? That's just easy. There are two possible ways. Just follow the direct link after you get access to my presentation, or visit our online catalog. Here we have Red Expert linked at different locations. And that's what I'm gonna show you now. So let's have a deeper look on how to get access to Red Expert and how you can create a new account or log into your existing personal one. First of all, visit our online catalog homepage. There you'll find the Red Expert button on the first page on the right side. By clicking the button, you'll access the start page of Red Expert. Second possibility to get access is via our Magic Power Module product pages on the online catalog. Here you can see the Red Expert icon beside every module. Big difference to the access via start page is that this linking leads directly to the Magic Power Module webpage on Red Expert with the respective power module selected. But before you access the Red Expert homepage, another window will show up. Within this login window, you're able to log in to your existing personal account or to create a new one. First of all, up here, you're able to set the language. Then use the first two boxes to type in the email address and the password of your personal account. Next step then is to click on the button login, and you'll see you're already done with the login process. If you don't have an existing account, use the button register to create one or continue as a guest user by clicking on continue without logging in. If you forgot your personal password, you can click on forgot your password and you'll be able to set a new password with assistance of our system. After the login process, if you don't already use our product pages of the online catalog, you will find yourself on the selection screen of Red Expert. Simply click on the Magic Power Module box, and there you go. You successfully entered our Magic Power Module section. So after the successful login to Red Expert, now we'll have a look on the basic structure and functionalities that Red Expert can offer. So overall, the layout is split in two main sections. Up here in blue, we have the specification table, which shows you parameters and features of all Magic Power Modules. Below in green, you can find all important module-related informations like graphs, block diagrams, or schematics. Here we have extracted the specification table to explain it more in detail. The table on its own is again split in two main sections. On the left side, all the specifications like input and output voltage of the modules are shown. But here you also find the module related information like order code, the product series, or the module package type. On the right side, the module features are displayed. Every column here corresponds to a specific feature we can offer with our modules. If the module fulfills a specific feature, it's ticked. Also, all data sheets for every Magic Power module is linked into the table. By clicking on the icon in the spec column, another window will show up with the respective data sheet of the module. So after the layout of the specification table, the question is, what can you do with it? So the table contains the filter function to guide you selecting the best fitting module for your application. Every column has its own filter icon, and by clicking on it, the needed field for filtering will pop up. Like it's shown for the example of the maximum output current here, you can fill in the needed minimum and maximum value. It's also possible just to fill in one of these two values. So different applications also require different value scaling. Therefore, you are able to select the just right scale to avoid possible decimal point errors. Of course, it's possible to set more than one filter at the same time to get a precise filter result. Also, the needed features can be set as a filter as well as further module related information. Next function of our specification table is the possibility to select more than one module at the same time. This functionality allows the user to compare the modules to each other. To select a module, just tick the box in the very first column. And underneath the table, you will find then a list on the selected modules in different color scales. With different colors, it's much easier to keep the modules apart. Now we got to know every functionalities of the specification table. Therefore, now I'll explain the module information part more in detail. Basically, we have four different panels, each consisting of three different boxes to sort the module related information into specific topics. What you can see on this slide is related to the basic information of the power module with its efficiency curve, the internal block diagram, as well as its typical schematic, showing you what additional components are needed to run the module. Further, we have information regarding the EMI behavior, EMI filtering, and the thermal behavior to select. Switching between the two panels is quite simple. Just click in the wanted panel. Then the click panel opens to the current selected one. And by clicking again on an already selected panel, it will get disabled again. If you want to have further information about a specific topic, we have all the information explained more in detail in our data sheets. Or you can contact our technical customer support. Our colleagues are always happy to support you with any arising question you may have. Now, what can you do to filter out your needed information with the shown graphs? First of all, select with the drop-down menus your application values. In this example, for the efficiency, it's mandatory to select the needed input and output voltage, as well as the ambient temperature. Here, only values are stored which are supported by the power module. All other values are grayed out. If you're done selecting the values, the respective curve is shown in the diagram. And as a registered user, you're able to use your given slider functionality. With this, you either can pull it on the needed x-axis value, or you can type it in the needed value and the slider will automatically move to the right position. After setting the slider position, the respective y-axis value will pop up in the spec table. For this specific example, you will set the needed output current of the power module and the efficiency for your adjusted operation point will pop up in the spec table. And now let's pretend you would like to compare two modules with each other. Like I explained it before, then you would need to tick the wished modules in the spec table. By selecting more than one module, the performance curves of all selected modules will show up in the diagram, so you can directly compare the performance of the modules at your adjusted operation point. Of course, you can set the slider to a specific x-axis value as well. So after the basic functionalities of RedExpert, now you'll get a deeper explanation about the thermal simulation section. But before we have a look on the implementation of the thermal simulation on RedExpert, I give you some information about how we developed our own thermal simulation model. The need to develop our own model is due to the added value we want to offer with RedExpert. Using our thermal simulation will always give accurate results within few seconds, which is uniquely possible for our own model. Now here you can see the usual buildup of our magic eval boards. The cross section shows the four layers of copper with isolation material FR4 in between. Normally the copper thickness is 70 micrometers with a board size of 80 by 80 millimeters. But we also use combinations with just two layers and 18 micrometers thickness for our isolated modules. And for our micro modules, the board size is half the size with copper thickness of 35 micrometers. To get the simulation done, it's necessary to understand the basic mechanisms of heat flow. There are three basic mechanisms of heat flow which need to be considered. First of all, there's internal heat conduction in the material leading the heat to the surface. From the surface, heat is emitted to the ambient either by heat radiation or convection. Main difference between these two lies in the way how they interact with the environment. By convection heats up the ambient, heat radiation will heat up the surrounding objects. So, first step, developing the thermal model, we divided the PCB in a grid of thermal resistances. Here you can see the grid with thermal resistances for the copper and FR4 is isolation material, as well as the junction case resistance within the module, which take the heat conduction into account. To consider the heat radiation and the convection, we also put the thermal resistance of the transition from the PCB surface to the ambient. And to get these complex mechanisms into a simplified thermal model, we only consider the conductive resistances within the materials. By doing this, we are able to describe the thermal relationships simply with Ohm's law, which allows to transform the complex steady state thermal model into an electrical one. This transformed electrical model is then simulated with the simulation tool LTSPICE. Here you can see the resulting grid model of the PCB. As you can see, we always simulate the thermal behavior of the magic power module in combination with the additional components placed on the PCB. This enables us not only to achieve exact simulation results, but also to perform a realistic simulation. Within the grid, we are able to simulate the temperature gradient at any point of the PCB. So after the explanation of the model development, we still need to compare the simulation with real measurements. Here we got the comparisons in between those two. Therefore, we compare the average deviation of every simulated or measured value in red, as well as the deviation at the case top of the module, which corresponds to the blue graph. With our simulation, we achieve a maximum deviation of plus minus 2 Kelvin as a result. But we need to consider that the thermal camera we used for measurements also has an accuracy of plus minus 2 Kelvin, which means with our simulation, we are just as accurate as our real measurement equipment. Now here you can see the three boxes for the thermal behavior panel. The box of the very left side shows the power loss of the magic power module at a certain operation point scaled over the output current of the power module. The middle box shows the simulated case top temperature versus the board area. And the last box on the right side contains a heat map of our evaluation board with all components placed showing the heat distribution at any point of the PCB. So after the general explanation, we will go through a step-by-step explanation of every box on its own. To handle the power loss section, you first set the needed operation point by selecting the right values of the drop-down menus. There again, you set the input and output voltage, and you can choose between 25 degrees and 85 degrees ambient temperature. Next step is to set the output current of the power module by using the slider. Last step is to read the corresponding power loss value out of the diagram, or as I said before, you can find the exact value popping up in the spec table. In this case, it would be a power loss of 2.01 watt at 2.7 amps. For the graph of the case top temperature again, set the required values with the drop-down menus. But in this case, you would need to set the power loss of the module which you got out of the power loss curve one step before. Now you set the slider on the board size, and the simulated board size will always represent a square PCB. Here you can see we would get 52.8 degrees at a board size of 64 square centimeters, which corresponds to our standard evaluation board size, by the way. For better understanding on this slide, I'd like to visualize the meaning of the just gained results. Like I told you before, the simulated PCB always corresponds to a squared shape. The maximum board size we simulate is 100 square centimeters. Our own standard magic evaluation board size is 64 square centimeters. And as an exception, our magic micro modules, because of their little solution size, have a board size of 16 square centimeters. The module on its own is placed on the middle of the board. And the result the user got is the temperature on the case top of the module at the set board size area with a certain selected power loss. The last box for the Fermi behavior section will give you information of the heat distribution on the PCB. For simulation, we use our own magic evaluation boards. Again, first step is to select the power loss as well as the ambient temperature with the given drop-down menus. In the background, the simulation will calculate the temperature at any point on the PCB, and the heat map will automatically show you the results. With the colored temperature scaling, the user is able to get a good feeling of the heat distribution. The user is also able to show the specific temperature value at a respective point on the PCB. To do this, just hover the mouse cursor to the wanted point on the PCB, and the value will appear on the temperature scale placed right to the heat map. Also, RedExpert will always automatically give you the hottest and lowest temperature value shown on the scale. So now we are settled with every input to handle RedExpert. Therefore, we should try to bring the theory into practice with an explicit selection example. For the selection process, I brought a nice industrial application with me. Here you can see a block diagram for the control of a stepper motor within an industrial environment. Typical applications consists of different functional units. In red, you can see the unit for powering the system. Here the system is powered by an industrial 24 volt bus supply. However, a 5 volt logic voltage is required for the electronic components, so that the supply voltage must be also converted from 24 volts to 5 volt. Yellow shows the data processing unit realized with a microcontroller. The green boxes are for the actual control of the motor using a motor driver, as well as the monitoring of the motor current to get information of the motor status. In gray color, we have the stepper motor, and blue shows the periphery communication interfaces, such as Ethernet and digital IOs. These are used to transmit the program drive profile and to provide data communication during operation. So what we now try to do is select the best fitting matching power module for this application in terms of thermal behavior. Most important information about the application is to have the target requirements defined. For the example, we would need a non-isolated power module, which can handle the 24-volt input voltage and supplies a 5-volt output voltage. Also, it should deliver up to 2 amp output current. For better control of the system, it should have an enable functionality as well as adjustable switching frequency and externally adjustable soft start. Now, as we defined our requirements, let's go to Root Expert and check what module fits best to these requirements. As you can see, I already prepared the filter settings like I showed you within this webinar before. Over the spec table, you can see the filter set. So after I inserted the target requirements, there are still 5 modules which fulfill the needed specifications. But the question now is, what module should be chosen to get the best fit in terms of thermal behavior? So luckily, it's possible to compare the modules with Red Expert. So let's just do this and compare these 5 modules using the thermal simulation on Red Expert. To get the comparison done, I selected all 5 modules by setting the ticks on the left side. As you can see, all the modules now showing up in the list beneath the table. And within the table, you get the values for the adjusted operation point for the power loss, as well as the case top temperature of the module, like I mentioned it before. So let's have a look on the performance curves of the 5 modules to filter out the best fit in between them. The first module with BQFN41 package approach has the highest power loss and therefore drops out of the list. The same goes for the next two 20263 modules. Having a higher power loss crosses them out of the list. So we got 2 remaining modules which will fit perfectly to the application and have optimal thermal behavior. Due to the fact there's only up to 5-volt output voltage required, the recommended module of choice would be the 171030601. But just in case, this leaves the 171032402 module as an alternative module. This leads us back to our application example. Due to the module selection with Red Expert, all the defined target requirements could be covered really quick. But as more than you expect, Red Expert gave us not only a thermally optimized solution, but also we could find an alternative solution which leads to a higher reliability of delivery and less system downtime for the customer. This shows the added value of a component selection with Red Expert. In addition to the possible fast component selection, you are able to optimize your system right from the start. So, thank you for joining our webinar. I hope I could give you some insights and practical guidance how to use our great designing tool. I will gladly answer any questions you may have now. For any questions that may not be answered, now feel free to contact our technical support hotline. We are happy to support you. Also, contact us in terms of support for design in, EMC filter design, layered review, or as I showed you today, thermal design. So now I will gladly answer all questions. So I see the first question. So the question is, why is the maximum simulated board size 100 square centimeters? That's a really good question. To answer this, the case top temperature versus board area chart need to be considered. So looking at the diagram, a kind of saturation behavior can be observed at this point. So this means that if the size of the board increases further, there's no additional cooling of the case top temperature. So to save simulation time, we just use this value as a maximum. I see the next question. So what is the PCB board area based on? And how many layers and what copper thickness is used for simulation? So as I already mentioned before, the simulation or simulated PCB of the Magic VDRM series are based on 70 micrometers copper thickness and 4 layers. And the Magic VDMM micromodule series are based on 35 micrometer copper thickness and also 4 layers. But of course, for any customized requests like 2-layer PCBs, we can do an extra simulation and provide the simulation data. So just send the request to our customer support at powermodules@we-online.com. So next question is, what magic do you have, minus 40 degrees to 100 degrees, not 85 degrees? If I understand the question right, it's about why we decided to put 25 degrees and 85 degrees. So basically, these are normal operation conditions, and so we used these two values for simulation. If I understand the question wrong, please could you please correct me? Okay, and I will gladly answer the next question. So the modeling is done based on 25 degrees ambient temperature. Has it been redone for 85 degrees? So yes, like I said, it's possible to select 85 degrees ambient temperature for the simulation and for the heat distribution. The power loss chart is based on real measurements and therefore not fully available for every component yet. But our measurements will be done, and therefore there will also be 85 degrees for the power loss chart. Next questions, are there modules available for automotive? So basically, yes, depends on the requirements. Or you can always contact us, our customer support hotline, and we gladly look for the perfect solution for your application. So like I said, the the hotline email address is powermodules@we-online.com. So another question. Why is the simulation done with LTSPICE and not with a CFD simulation tool like ANSYS? So that's a real, real good question. So the huge advantage of our way of simulation is the resulting simulation speed. So a CFD model is not only take a lot of time and effort to create, it also takes a lot of time to simulate, and we use a power loss step size of 0.1 watt, and with our simulation tool you get the results within seconds, a few seconds really. So maybe a CFD model would be a little more precise, but like I said, showed before, we are just as accurate as our measurement equipment, and therefore we gain a lot of simulation speed. So there's one more question. Are there any costs for creating an account on Red Expert, or is it for free? So of course, creating an account is completely free of charge for our customers. So waiting for the next question, just a little hint. Of course, you can, or if you don't have a question now, but there are some new questions will arise after the presentation, you can always contact me with under my email address, or just contact our customer support hotline, and we will gladly answer all questions.